ISUPK.
Hey, salam, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK. And the commander Johnny Ayala in California, man. Telling all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And it's there with that. Salam.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Hispanics and Native Americans are a holy people to the Lord thy God. The word
means separate. I'm going to prove it to you in just a second. Keep reading.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people.
To be a what?
Special people.
An equal people.
Special people.
The Bible says the Lord God has chosen blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to be a special people, man. Last time I checked, special wasn't equal. Our civil rights leaders and the protests that we joined thinking it's going to fix our problems, are fight for us to be equal, just for us to matter. When the Bible says not only do we matter, we are the only people that matter, man.
That's right.
We are a special people according to the God of this Bible, man.
That's right.
Keep reading.
Special people unto himself.
Unto himself, man. Yeah. The Lord loves our people. That's why America hates for any black Hispanic or Native American to identify as a Jew.
Right.
Because that would mean that God loves us and he hates them.
That's right.
And that's in the Bible. Give me Romans 9 and 13. That's in the Bible, man. God loves one set of people. And it doesn't look like it's us because look at how we live. Look at our oppression. Look at the ghettos. Look at the burials. Look at the reservations, man. We live in hell wherever we are. But guess what? That should be the proof that we're the special people. That in and of itself is proof. I don't understand how some white man can ever claim to be a Jew when the Bible says the Jews are immortal. We'll bring it out. Tell them where you at.
The book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
The Bible says, as it is written. As it is written where? In this very book we read right here. See, the problem with the Christian church, the problem with the Catholic church, the problem with Islam and all religion is we never learn the truth according to this book right here. We never learn these things going to church all our lives with grandma. We never learn this, man. When the Bible says, as it is written, keep reading.
Jacob, have I loved?
The Bible says, Jacob, have I loved. Who is Jacob according to the Bible? Jacob is the people on this side right here. The 12 tribes of Israel. Our forefather is Jacob. That's who we come from through our bloodline. So many of us go on Ancestry.com, 23andMe, DNA websites to find out who we are, just to get lied to some more. Oh, I'm 15% from Nigeria, and then 3% from Ireland, and then 17% Native American, and all type of garbage, man. The Bible has our lineage. The Bible has our ancestry. The Bible has our history. And according to our history, we come from a man named Jacob. And this is what the Lord says about our forefather. Read it again.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
The Bible says, as it is written, Jacob have I loved. The Lord loves our people, man. And only our people. If you're on this side, the Lord loves you, man. If you're not on this side, you're going to find out how the Lord feels about you. Keep reading.
What? Esau have I hated.
But who?
Esau.
But who?
Esau.
Esau, according to the Bible, can anybody guess? If you never heard, Esau, according to the Bible, is who we call today the so-called white man. That's the so-called white man. Christ came from the tribe of Judah. Judah's on this side right here, one of the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
The Most High loves Christ. Christ is an Israelite, the same like us, black man. Christ came out of the ghettos. The Bakwasha just brought it up. The brother just brought it up. Christ came the same way we live. Christ was born in the ghettos, he was poor, he went through the same trials and tribulations we went through. But Christ conquered life, man. And because he conquered life, he conquered death. That we have a chance now to get it right. You know why? Because the Lord loves us.
Right.
The Lord wants us to get it right, man. The Lord wants his children to come back to hell. But that's what the Bible says about Esau, the so-called white man, man. This is the problem with the church. We've never learned these things, man. We should at least know who the people in the Bible are, but we went to church all these years and learned absolutely nothing. You know what we learned how to do in church? Sing and dance. We learned to become great entertainers for America. Like Nick Cannon. Where do you think Nick Cannon got all those skills from? Nick Cannon learned to be such a great entertainer from church. The same way we all learn, man. But Nick Cannon never learned courage, according to the Bible. He never learned how to stand up for his people in this Bible, man. That's why you see these brothers back here. We too were on the other side. We too were cowards and drug dealers and liars and all types of things that America wants us to be. But we picked up this book and found out that this book tells blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to stand up for your people, man. To do what's right. Read it again.
Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
How about what?
Have I hated.
How about what?
Have I hated.
Spell this word, brother. Spell that word.
H-A-T-E-D.
I thought we learned in church God loves everybody. Didn't we hear that all our lives? God doesn't hate. God loves everybody. We all God's children. Well, if God loves everybody, why does it say God hates? Read it again.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Why does it say that God hates when we've been taught that God loves everybody? Somebody's lying. Either the people that told us God loves everybody was lying, or this book is lying. This book is not lying, man. That's why they don't want us to pick the book up. That's why they made Nick Cannon apologize for speaking the truth about the black man being the real Jews, according to the Bible. You know why? Because God hates the so-called white man.
That's right.
God hates America
right.
for their treatment of his children,
oh,
man.
That's right.
You think God is pleased with how they're treating blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans? Look at how George Floyd died, man. Look at how Sandra Bland died, man. Look at how Freddie Gray, Tamir Rice. How old was Tamir Rice? 12? Tamir Rice was 12 years old, man. Who would have ever thought at 12 years old, like, damn, I'm not gonna make it. I know in the ghettos, we know in our head, like, I hope to make it to 18. But damn, 12? Hey, 25. And growing up black, Hispanic, and Native American in America, we got milestones we try to hit. Like, I hope I make it to 18. I hope I make it to 21. I hope I make it to 25. I hope I make it to 30. After 30, we're just like, yeah, life is good.
It's good.
Life is future. I got red bottoms on. Life is good.
Life is good.
Yep. Kanye West made a song about making the past 25. But who would have ever thought that we would have this second guess if we would make it to the age of 12, man? You know why? Because we live in a place where it's absolutely okay to murder black men. We live in a place, if you're white, man, it's okay to murder black men. It's okay to oppress the Lord's children. This is why the Bible says God hates Esau. Not because of his skin color, not because they're white. We don't care about their skin color, man. God hates the oppressor because of his crimes.
That's right.
Give me Obadiah 1 and 10, man. Because of their crimes against God's children.
That's right.
Let me ask you something, man. If you have a child and somebody is bullying your child every single day, wouldn't you feel some type of way about that person that's messing with your child? A good parent would. A good parent would want to deal with that bully that's messing with their child. Guess what? We are the Lord's children. And this is why God hates the so-called white man. Because they have dealt with us wicked in America, man. They have oppressed us. Hung us from tree to tree. The same way Christ was hung from a tree, man. You know why? Because Christ is a black man according to the Bible. And we are descendants of the real Jews according to the Bible. Read that.
The book of Obadiah, chapter 4, verse 10. For thy blonde.
For thy what?
Thy blonde.
For thy skin color.
Thy blonde.
For thy blonde hair.
Thy blonde.
For thy blue eyes.
Thy blonde.
The Bible says, for thy violence, man. This is why God hates the white man. This is why God hates America. Read it again.
No,
for thy
dude.
Violence.
Yeah,
for thy violence, man. We don't hate the white man because he's white. We hate the white man because look at how they treat our people. Look at what they have done to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans after 400 years. What have black people done to deserve this treatment? We've served all throughout America. We fought in all their wars. We nursed all their babies. Black women used to breastfeed white babies while little black babies went hungry. Black men used to protect little black boys and show them how to hunt. You know, white people hate their kids. They don't raise their own kids today.
Right.
Go look at rich white families. Who raising their kids? The black daddy. The Benjamite, the sisters from Jamaica, from the islands. The Latino sisters, man. That's who's raising their kids. You know why? Because we care for this place. We love these people. And what happens when we love America? When we love the white man? They return our love with hate. And that's how it's been for 400 years, man. And this is why God hates America. Read it again.
Obadiah chapter 1, verse 10. For thy violence.
And this is why God is going to punish America. Read it.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob.
We just found out earlier, Jacob, according to the Bible, are the 12 tribes of Israel. If you are black, Hispanic, or Native American, your forefather, according to the Bible, is Jacob. We come from the same bloodline. And the Bible says because of the violence against the children of Israel, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans,
shame shall cover thee.
Shame shall cover thee, man. The world looks at America, and America is no longer that shining city on the hill. America is no longer looked at as the land of the free and the home of the brave. You know why? Because the whole earth has witnessed America's treatment of our people, man. They have witnessed how much of a hypocrite America is to say, this is the land of the free and home of the brave. When we are killed in the streets by cowards, when we are gunned down, our 12-year-olds, our women, it'd be different if they were just murdering black men. It's still wrong. But in a war, you know men murder men. These coward bastards murder our women and our children, man. They killed that sister Corinne Gaines in Baltimore in front of her 2-year-old son, man. They have no regard for our people.
That's right.
They don't love our people. They got Hispanic cages. They got Hispanic babies in cages right now, man. And you try to tell me it's the land of the free, home of the brave? America is a shameful place. God says so, man. God says so. That's not worthy. The God of the Bible says it's a shameful place. Read it again.
For thy blood against thy brother James, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever.
This is the future of America. This is the future of the so-called oppressor, who we know as the white man, man. Y'all think America's gonna continue to go on? We finding out, look at America now. The coronavirus got DC shut down. The coronavirus got America shut down. Look, this place is not gonna keep going on forever, man. The Lord is trying to show us he's getting ready to destroy this place. And the Bible says, this is the future of the so-called white man. Read it again.
For thy blood, and the day that thou stoodest on the other side, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever.
Shame shall cover thee. That's what the Bible says. You know why? Because as long as they are in authority, the world is in mourning, man. As long as America is in power, as long as the white man is in power, black people are always going to be on the bottom. And so Latinos and Hispanics. You know why? So because all the races on the earth have made a covenant with the so-called white man. Give me Psalms 83:3. All the races of the earth have came together with one consent. You know why? Because they know we are the real Jews according to the Bible. Not those people that have the land right now. Those people in the land of Israel fighting back and forth with the Palestinians and the Arabs, those are imposters according to the Bible.
That's right.
Those people that go to that synagogue right there on 6th Street, they are liars.
Right.
They are the synagogue of Satan.
Right.
They are the devil the Bible speaks of, and they are not the real Jews.
That's right.
And guess what? You make a clip out of this. This is not anti-Semitism. This is the truth. What America has done to our people for 400 years is the epitome of anti-Semitism, man.
That's right.
America's treatment of our people is exactly what the Bible is saying. They shall be cut off forever because of their violence, man. We come out here and speak on behalf of the real Jews. We speak in defense of the real Jews.
If you heard, keep reading.
Psalms 83, verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel.
Read it again.
They have taken crafty counsel.
The Bible says they have taken crafty counsel, man. What does the word crafty mean? The word crafty means slick, wise. The Bible says they have taken slick counsel against thy people, man. Keep reading.
They consulted against thy hidden one. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
This is why Nick Cannon had to apologize for speaking the truth about blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans being the real Jews. This is why Deshaun Jackson had to apologize for speaking the truth about blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans being the real Jews. Read it again.
If that is that, come and let us cut them off.
And let us what?
Cut them off.
Let us what?
Cut them off for being a nation.
This is America's goal. America wants to cut off blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans from being a nation, man. From being a people. You know why? If blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans were our own people, America would thrive. We wouldn't work for them. We would work for our own. If we have black businesses, we wouldn't spend money in white businesses.
Right.
It's common sense. You know what I'm saying? Why would we give our money to a people that hate us when we can give our money to a brother? This brother right here selling these drinks. I would rather give my money to this brother right here selling drinks than some devil any day, man.
Right.
Right. I'd rather give my money to this brother right here than to step foot in a Walgreens. You understand? I'd rather pay some sister to fry some chicken and rice than to go to one of these Chinese restaurants, man. You know why? Because when we are a nation, we don't need anybody else. But America has destroyed our people so much that we feel like we need them for everything. And that's so they can cut us off from being a nation. Keep reading.
That the name of Israel may be no more in the river.
That the name of who?
Israel.
Read it from the top.
Psalms 83 verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden one. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
This is America's goal. They want to cut us off from being our own people. That's why they pay civil rights leaders to come and hijack our movement, man. Black people were fighting for civil rights. When I say civil rights, I mean the civil rights movement was started by black men that only wanted equal pay. Black men that simply wanted to be paid equally. But the oppressor knew that if we kept having our own black businesses, if we kept having our own economy, that America would fall. That's why, brother, because America knows that. That's crafty counsel that they took. They understand that. They understand if we would have continued like that for 40 more years, there would be no America. They'll be coming to you for water in your store, giving you their money. Their kids will be paying you so you can send your kids to college. But now, they hijacked the civil rights movement. Now, we have no businesses. We have no banks. We have no hospitals. We give all our money and resources and love to another nation while we suffer on the bottom. We gotta go to these stores and they treat us like garbage, man.
Right.
You gotta go to the hair store for your woman. And the Chinese people follow you around.
Right.
Like, we make you rich. Why are you following me around? I'ma pay for it. We go to the Africans, they treat us like garbage. The Arabs, they treat us like garbage. The white man treats us like garbage. This is the plan from the jump, man. To cut us off from being a nation.
That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent.
The Bible says every race of people outside of our people has come together with one consent. Meaning this, every race of people can agree on one thing. And that one thing is, we have to keep the blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans on the bottom. Every race of people can agree on that one thing. You know why? Because if we were not on the bottom, where would we be?
At the top.
The tippy top, man. Get it, brother, in the hand. That's right, brother. At the goddamn top. That's who we are as a people. Look what we do in oppression. Look at black men in the ghetto right now. We born in the worst conditions, we eat the worst food, and we produce the best athletes.
Right.
We produce the smartest minds. We produce the most intelligent people ever, man. The strongest, the fastest. Look at black women, man. Look at blacks, Hispanics, Native American women. They grew up in the ghetto eating Cheez-Its and ramen noodles and all type of garbage. They step up to be the baddest women on the face of the earth.
That's right.
You know that's the Lord, man. You know that's the Lord. We are the Lord's special people, man. And if we were on the bottom, we would be on top. And that's why nobody's allowed to say the Jews are black without repercussions.
Right.
Guess what? Brothers back here not worried about being canceled. Cancel culture doesn't apply to the prophet, to the Lord, man.
Right.
Cancel culture doesn't apply to the man back here.
Right.
Cancel culture does not apply to the Lord, man. And that's why we can't ever be shut down, because we speak for the Lord. We speak for the God of the Bible, man.
Yeah,
and he wants his children to know they are special. They are the real Jews, man. The fact that we don't know that speaks volumes that our leaders have failed us, man.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm and blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With